Tommy was a whirlwind of energy. He loved exploring. Every corner held a mystery for him to unravel. His curiosity, a burning flame, often led him to forbidden territories.
One place stood out, the attic door at the end of the hallway.
Tommy's parents knew his adventurous spirit. They cautioned him about the attic, a place shrouded in whispers and shadows. It was out of bounds, they said, a sanctuary for forgotten things.
But I felt an irresistible pull towards the unknown. I imagined the attic held treasures untold, ancient relics and forgotten stories. I yearned to uncover its secrets.
The warning only fueled his desire. One afternoon, with his parents gone, the attic's allure became too strong to resist. The house stood silent. Sunlight streamed through the windows, painting dusty squares on the floor. The air hung heavy with the quiet hum of an empty house. It was a day like any other, except it wasn't.
My parents were gone. They had ventured out, leaving me in the care of silence. It was an opportunity I'd been waiting for, a chance to finally uncover what lay beyond the attic door.
Excitement bubbled in his chest, a drum against his ribs. He tiptoed towards the hallway. Each step felt heavy, echoing in the stillness. The air grew colder as he approached the attic door. A shiver ran down his spine, a mixture of fear and anticipation.
I reached for the doorknob, its brass cold under my touch. It creaked as I turned it, a sound that seemed to echo through the silent house.
The attic door swung open, an invitation into the unknown. The attic was a cavern of darkness, a place where light dared not linger. Dust motes danced in the slivers of light that pierced through cracks in the boarded-up windows, creating an eerie, almost magical atmosphere. The air was thick with the smell of decay and the musty scent of forgotten things, a testament to the years of neglect and abandonment.
I stepped inside, my heart pounding against my ribs, each beat echoing in the silence.
Cobwebs, thick and grey, clung to every surface, weaving a tapestry of neglect. Furniture draped in white sheets loomed like phantoms in the dim light, their shapes distorted and ghostly. It was a place frozen in time, where the past lingered like a stubborn shadow. A graveyard for memories and discarded dreams, each item a relic of a bygone era.
I felt a shiver crawl up my spine, a cold finger tracing my vertebrae. I took a tentative step forward, my footfall muffled by the thick layer of dust on the floor, each step a cautious venture into the unknown.
Each creak of the floorboard sounded unnaturally loud in the silence, a reminder of the fragile nature of the old wood. He felt a presence in the attic, something unseen watching him, a pair of eyes hidden in the shadows.
I pushed those thoughts aside, focusing on the task at hand. I was here to explore, to uncover the secrets hidden beneath layers of dust and time, to find what had been lost to the ages.
He ventured deeper into the attic, his eyes adjusting to the gloom, the darkness becoming less intimidating with each step. He was determined to find the treasure he knew was hidden somewhere in this forgotten place, a treasure that held the key to untold stories and mysteries. His search led him to an old chest, its surface covered in dust and cobwebs, a relic from a time long past. With trembling hands, he opened the chest, revealing its contents, a collection of items that spoke of a life once lived, now forgotten. Old photographs and letters, yellowed with age, told stories of love, loss, and dreams that never came to be. As he sifted through the memories, he couldn't help but feel a connection to the past. A sense of understanding and empathy for those who had come before him. He left the attic with a newfound sense of purpose, the secrets he had uncovered giving him a deeper appreciation for the fragility and beauty of life.
He stumbled upon a trunk tucked away in a corner, almost hidden from view, as if it had been waiting for someone to find it. It was unlike anything else in the attic, standing out amidst the clutter of forgotten memories and dusty relics. Not shrouded in dust, but radiating an unnatural cleanliness, as if it had been meticulously cared for despite its hidden location. The wood was a deep mahogany, polished to a shine that seemed to capture and reflect the dim light filtering through the attic window. Strange symbols glowing faintly were etched into its surface, their meaning lost to time, but their presence undeniable.
The symbols pulsed with an inner light, calling to him as if they held secrets that only he could unlock. Tommy felt an irresistible urge to open the trunk, a compulsion that overrode any sense of caution or fear. He knew, with a certainty that chilled him to the bone, that this was what he had been searching for, even if he hadn't known it until this moment. This was the heart of the attic's mystery, the key to understanding the strange occurrences and eerie feelings that had always surrounded this place.
His fingers trembled as he reached for the latch. It was cold to the touch, as if the metal itself was alive, sending a shiver up his spine. With a click that echoed through the attic, the trunk swung open, revealing its contents with a sense of ceremony. The musty smell vanished, replaced by the scent of rain and old books, a fragrance that spoke of ancient knowledge and forgotten tales. Inside, nestled on a bed of faded velvet, lay a book, its presence commanding attention. It was bound in leather, the color of aged parchment, its cover worn but still exuding an aura of mystery and importance. The same glowing symbols from the trunk adorned its cover, linking the two objects in a way that felt both deliberate and profound.
Tommy reached for the book, his hand drawn to it as if by an unseen force, feeling a connection that transcended time and space. He knew that opening this book would change everything, revealing secrets that had been hidden for generations.
The moment his fingers brushed against the leather, the attic plunged into an unnatural chill. It was as if the very air around him had been sucked out, leaving a vacuum of cold that gnawed at his skin. The air grew thin, making it difficult to breathe. Each breath felt like a struggle, as if the atmosphere itself was conspiring against him. The symbols on the book flared, casting grotesque shadows that danced across the walls. These shadows seemed almost alive, writhing and twisting in a macabre ballet.
Tommy hesitated, a flicker of fear battling with his overwhelming curiosity. His heart pounded in his chest, each beat echoing in the silent, eerie attic. But it was too late. The book beckoned him, its call echoing in the silence of his mind. It was as if the book had a voice of its own, whispering secrets that only he could hear. He couldn't resist its allure. His fingers tightened around the book, lifting it from its velvet cradle. The weight of the book felt significant, as if it held the weight of countless stories and secrets.
As he opened the book, a gust of wind slammed the attic door shut. The sound echoed through the attic, a final resounding note of isolation. The only source of light vanished, plunging the attic into absolute darkness. It was a darkness so profound that it felt almost tangible, wrapping around him like a suffocating blanket. Tommy was trapped, enveloped by a cold that seeped into his bones. The chill was relentless, gnawing at him from the inside out. He tried to call out, but his voice died in his throat. He was alone. The silence was deafening, pressing down on him with an almost physical weight.
The book lay open in his lap, its pages filled with swirling symbols that seemed to writhe and shift before his eyes. Each symbol seemed to pulse with a life of its own, drawing him deeper into its mysteries. He felt a presence beside him, cold and menacing. It whispered his name, a sibilant hiss that sent shivers down his spine. The voice was ancient, filled with a malevolent glee that promised nothing but despair. The house shuddered, a groan escaping its old bones. The air crackled with an unseen energy, a palpable tension that vibrated through every floorboard and rafter. Walls pulsed with a faint, eerie glow, emanating from the heart of the house, the attic. Downstairs, furniture rattled and shook. Pictures on the walls tilted, their frames clattering against the walls as if an unseen hand tried to straighten them. Shadows stretched and contorted, twisting familiar shapes into grotesque mockeries. The house was changing, warping around the boy trapped within its attic. It was feeding off his fear, his isolation growing stronger with each passing moment. It was becoming something else. The once warm and inviting home had transformed into a menacing entity. It was a predator that had caught its prey, slowly tightening its grip, ready to consume the boy and his curiosity whole.